Okay, well, this is the offending item, the gotcha. I have to say, actually, I am very pleased to get it because the whole thing was a huge laugh. I was totally fooled, totally, totally fooled. Everybody else in the whole building, it seemed, knew about it, and certainly they soon realised, but Muggins here, I never realised. And the reason why it worked, I think, so brilliantly is because there I was, just doing my ordinary job in my own seat, doing what comes naturally, if you like. It was the end of a long studio session. It was the 24th programme we'd recorded in the week. We were all getting tired. And so it was just so natural. So when things began to go wrong, I just thought, well, it's the end of the week and things just go wrong.
So Carol was in on it. Dictionary Corner was in on it. Obviously the contestants were in on it, but poor Richard Whiteley wasn't in on it.
Will you please welcome two contestants, brand new contestants, Amanda Richards and Richard Max. His mobile phone just gone off.
Good word, embarrassed for the moment, really.
No, I'm on now. I'm on.
I don't believe this.
It's my mother.
Oh, well, let me speak to her. Let me speak to her.
Hold on, Richard wants to say hello. Francis, name's Francis.
Francis, he's on the programme. He's off the line. Well, he hasn't finished. Right, we're on the air. You'll see this later on. Okay. Oh, shut up. Shut up. Francis!
Calm yourself, woman.
Calm down, woman. Woman. Yes, I know you watch it all the time. Yes. Turn it off. Thank you. Bye-bye, Francis.
Right. Thanks.
I don't believe it.
Hello?
Sorry. His mother.
It's my mum. I didn't think I was going to be on.
So here we go now with a letters game from Richard Max. Amanda.
I've got diarrhea.
That's fantastic. What about you, Richard?
Yeah, I've got diarrhea too.
I have to say that we've got diarrhoea as well. Have you not got diarrhoea?
No, it's pathetic, isn't it?
Just... You know, it's a collection of bowels and continents, basically. Isn't it?
Well. Anyway, it's 9 points. It's 18 points to them both, everyone. Fantastic. Well, what a show. What a show. Richard, help us.
Oh, right. Amanda Richards, who is, of course, an anagram of that great ambulance chaser, Dr. Damien Crash. This is a small poem for her, a little limerick. There was a young woman called Richards whose hobby was going to the pictures. She liked Dumb and Dumber and Gone with the Wind, but best of all, she liked Saving Private Ryan.
Didn't get it.
I think I did another. I'm not sure. I think it needs work, that, doesn't it?
Let's now move on to round six. With you, Amanda, please.
Vowel, please, Carol.
Thank you. O.
Consonant.
M.
And a vowel.
E.
Consonant.
T.
Another consonant.
H.
A vowel.
I.
A consonant.
N.
Consonant.
G.
Consonant, please.
And,
Well, let's start the clock. Okay, Amanda, how many?
Five.
What? Five? Richard?
No, six.
Okay, well, we can play the game. What's your five, Amanda?
Shine.
Right, Richard, what's your six?
Homing.
Right. Homing, is that okay?
Well, yeah, that's fine. I mean, it's surprising. There are longer ones than that. There's hinges for six as well. is moisten for seven.
Well, is it me being daft? There is a nine letter word there, isn't there? Something.
For what?
Is it?
What is it?
It's what?
Why?
What something?
Two rounds to go, 623. 623, here we go. Okay, 623 then, Amanda.
No, nothing.
Richard?
Yeah, 623.
Okay, well, let's hear it. Richard and Carol?
Six.
Six. Time.
Two. Three.
You mean like that? No, you can't do that.
Not in the rules. Sorry. I've not seen that before.
Sorry, no, you haven't seen that before. Only in silly programmes. No, it did. It did say that. It did.
Are you sure?
Yes, it did.
No, you have to do adding, subtraction, multiplication, or division.
Richard, yeah. Look me in the eye. You know you're talking a lot of bugs, don't you? You know the rules very well, don't you?
I'm sure I've seen it.
You haven't seen it, Richard. You know the rules very well.
You're just trying to put me off.
No. Yes, you're putting Amanda off, for goodness sake.
I wasn't. I thought you could. Does it say anything about whether, you know, you have to multiply or subtract?
It does. Yes, it does. They told how to do it. They won't let you go, you wired it.
He's trying to put me off.
No, he's not really trying to put you off purposely.
It's not fair.
He's just, no, it's okay.
I don't really need to sit next to me. Okay.
Well, you can't sit here because... No, you can't sit here because of the way the programme runs. You've got to sit there, okay. Okay,
anyway. You know that I'm doing really bad.
Yes,
isn't it? Is it possible you could tell me the answer to the conundrum and then at least... But I'm really losing badly.
No, you're not losing badly.
And if you told me that he wouldn't win anyway.
No, I can't tell you that. Honestly, though, I do know. He's not trying to put you off.
I mean,
Okay, we'll do another numbers game, okay? And he'll know the rules. Okay, and then we'll do the conundrum. You've got a good score. You come up for it. No, I can't tell you the conundrum.
Guys, Jenny, do you want me to get these down?
Okay, well, now we go to the conundrum. So this is where we have the nine-letter word, all muddle up. First person to unmuddle it against the clock gets the point. So please now reveal today's countdown conundrum. Well, it was meant to be education, but I don't think it was it? Honkat, let's see what is it.
So, a short time ago, you were the only person without diarrhea. How are you now?
I've got it now, I can tell you.
So there we have our comic relief.